little bit of R&B fans up in here. I heard y'all just a tad bit. All right, so we're gonna get into this next song. This is an original song. You know, after you get booed up with somebody, right? You let them know you're a dope queen, you done got booed up and everything like that. And then all of a sudden you start realizing some things is going on, you know? They start getting a little selfish and, you know, you're like, oh man, you know, I think I was dealing with a boy and not a king, you know what I'm saying? So I gotta talk to the selfish boys, the ones that want that cake and eat it too. This is called Selfish Boy.
Don't worry.
had to represent Philly right quick.
I don't know if y'all know, Frankie Beverly
Amaze
is from Philadelphia.
Okay.
Y'all didn't know that, did y'all? Okay. Had to let y'all know what was up with the what's up. So how y'all feeling so far?
Woo!
Yes. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. So, again, my name is Suzann Christine. For those of y'all who do not know who I am, singer-songwriter from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. And I put out a song a while back. It's called Save Me. And I wrote this song along with one of my colleagues, Jason Cook. This song is one of those songs where sometimes, you know, you're in a situation where you just came out of a relationship and you're just feeling down and you're feeling empty, you're just feeling like you just need somebody to help you through those next moments, right? And, you know, anybody could come and be the person that helps you on through to the next situation to make you feel better from the situation that you're currently in. It could be your dog, it could be your cat, it could be your best friend, your sister, your brother, somebody. So I wrote this song, it's called Save Me, along with Jason Cook. Let's get it.
I'm
Come together with this next song. You know what? I want to start that over real quick. Hold on. So, that song is called Savior. Very special song. I'm going to get into these next songs right here. It's called 21 and Don't Rush It. I released everything. A lot of the songs that I have is actually available on iTunes, Google Play, Spotify, Tidal. So if you are liking what you're hearing thus far, make sure you take out your phones. If you're on Spotify, if you're on Tidal, take out your phones. Make sure you follow me on those platforms, because that's how you really, truly can support artists these days right now, is if you either download us on iTunes or if you're going to stream us. And also, I'm going to take this moment to ask you guys to go to my website, SuzannChristine.com. There is a contact tab because I want to stay connected with you all. I would love to receive your email. So there's a little join our mailing list on the contact tab on SuzannChristine.com. I spell my name a lot different than any other Suzanne that you're going to meet. It's S-U-Z-A-N-N, no E, Christine, C-H-R-I-S-T-I-N-E. But 21, I wrote this song, it has two different meanings. Everybody anticipates the age 21, right? When you're growing up? All right, now listen. It's very quiet. I want to make sure I feel your energy so that I can, like, give y'all a lot more of me. I have a lot to give, I really do. So y'all got to talk back to me. We're in an intimate space. Everybody anticipates the age of 21 growing up, right? Okay. All right, yes, it's a big deal. Everybody needs to celebrate. People are taking trips. People are going out with their friends. They no longer need those fake IDs. I didn't have a fake ID. But, you know, I'm sure a lot of people have fake IDs so they can get into the clubs and drink and do the things that they want to do, rent cars or whatever it may be, right? And, you know, another meeting for 21 is, do we have any gamblers? Any gamblers in the house? Raise your hand, make some noise. Yeah. You can be quiet if you just, you know, oh, I don't want people to know I'm a gambler. A lot of people don't want that to be known. I get it. But, blackjack, what's the number that you need to reach?
21.
21, right? So it's that lucky number, right? You're feeling lucky. So I wrote this song 21 because it's a number that people anticipate. It's a lucky number. And then I wrote a song called Don't Rush It, so I'm going to give you a little bit of that too, because that's how I truly, truly feel about love sometimes. So we're going to get into it. I'm good. bigger than love, don't we? Don't rush it. Thank you. So, we are in a time where there's a lot going on the planet, a lot going on in the world. And with everything that's been going on in the world, we've lost a lot of great people, a lot of innocent people, a lot of loving people. And, you know, I'm a big fan of artists who make sure they make it a point to talk about the things that are going on in the world. And with that being said, 3 years ago, I was down in Atlanta working with one of my producers, and we had just lost Sandra Bland. Do we know who Sandra Bland is? And when we lost her, even though we had lost so many before due to police brutality, losing Sandra really hit home for me. Because all I could picture was myself driving somewhere down in the South by myself, not putting on my turn signal like I do a lot of times, getting pulled over by somebody that's racist, and being in a jail cell, and the next thing I know, I don't even have my life anymore. My mom doesn't get to see me, my family doesn't get to see me, and, you know, it just really pulled on my heart, you know? And so, with all of those things that have been going on, I felt like I needed to ask this one question.
Living free, hey, so the days are racing, and I'm living in the
listen, if we learn to love ourselves first, right, then we can love on others. We can share our love. Appreciate the people around you. Show them love. Let's choose the love first. We all have that power of hate too. Because hate is a powerful thing. Okay? But listen, if we learn to love, that's more powerful. More powerful. We can change things. We can change our lives, or we can change other people's lives if we choose to love first. Y'all feel that? And I make y'all repeat after me because words have power. Understand, they don't call it spelling for nothing. Because words are spelled. So make sure you tell yourself some great things and make sure you tell other people in your circle and around you great things. Because those words you say off your tongue have power. Choose love, love, one more time. You know, if you like it, sing along.
You die.
How y'all feeling?
Good.
Y'all feeling good?
Yeah.
That's what I want to make y'all feel. I want to make y'all feel good. You know, that's why you're here to raise your vibrations up a little bit. So if you came in here a little down, you should be feeling a little bit better right now. Right? Okay. All right now. Now, I have not done this, and I'm like, 7 songs in, and that's a problem. But I'm gonna do it real quick, and I wanna see who knows it first. And then we can see, we can join in for the people who don't know, okay? Who that?
Who that?
Oh, who that?
Suzann.
Y'all is doing it. Now I gotta find out if y'all know what Suzann means. Anybody know what Suzann stands for?
Let us know.
That's all right. If you don't know, that's good. All right. It's right up here, though. So it's my hashtag. My hashtag is Suzann, S-U-D-A-T. I'm silly. I know. My hashtag is Suzann. So if you're posting videos or anything like that on Instagram or on social media, my hashtag is Suzann. But people call me Sue for short. That's number one, right? Now, the S stands for spiritual, the U for unique, the D for divine, the A for artistic, and the T for thankful. That's what Suzann stands for. Spiritual, unique, divine, artistic, and thankful, because that's who I am. And I'm sure there's a lot of you out here in the audience that feel that same way, that you're a spiritual, unique, divine, artistic, and thankful person. Yes?
Yes.
So who that?
Suzann.
Yes, that's love, that's love. So we're gonna jump into this next record. This is one of my first singles I released a long time ago. It's called Adrenaline Rush.
Thank you.
So this next song right here is called Fly, and I put this out during Black History Month, 2017. The years are going by really quickly, y'all. I don't know what's going on. Time just, whew. But anyway, it's called Fly. Fly stands for Forever Love Yourself. F-L-Y. Forever Love Yourself. So let's get into it. Thank you. Can we give up to Eki? She's the reason why I'm here. Can we give up to her? Her and Steve, they found out about me. Well, Steve knew about me. But then they heard I was coming up to New York, and I'm like, what? We got to get her at the Williamsburg Music Center. I'm like, all right, what's that? I'm here. So 7 years ago, I quit my full-time job to pursue my music career, pursue my dream. Woo! And it has been a lovely journey full of peaks and valleys, but it has been amazing, and I don't regret one second of the ride. And, you know, when I quit that job, it was one of those things where I just was feeling like, okay, you know, a lot of people are not happy with this decision. And, you know, sometimes when you're making tough decisions, you're making decisions for yourself, not everybody is going to support that decision. But you have to keep going, and you have to live your life for you. So at that time, I wrote a song called Just Wanna Live, and I hope you can, you know, let it resonate, and I hope you can relate. Just wanna live. Volunteers, y'all. Yes.
I love this song.
So, if you know it, sing the darn law. And listen, Ben, come down, because I really got to hear myself on this, all right? Thank you.
Thank you.
name is right here, y'all. I told y'all, I spell it different than anybody else. My name is Suzann Christine. I spell it S-U-Z-A-N-N. I'm sorry. C-H-R-I-S-T-I-N-N. What? Oh, shoot. Y'all gonna see Pat with me all the time. She takes care of me. Make sure I'm good. Anyway, my name is Suzann Christine, and I wanna say thank y'all so much again. And I do have merchandise in the back. So if you became a Suzann fan and you wanna represent the Suzann crew, you can be a Suzann person too. There's shirts in the back, Suzann. See my mom. Mom, raise your hand. Right there, she got a shirt on. We got CDs, a couple CDs back there. We got a few visors. I made these visors. We sold out of a lot of them the last show. So I think I only have two left. So I gotta make some more. I think I said everything. Merchandise, CDs, visors. And listen, go to SuzannChristine.com. We need to connect with you so y'all can know where I'm at. Because y'all know how Instagram is. And I just can't text everybody all the time that I got a show. I just can't do it. Come on. So, if y'all could go to my website, SuzannChristine.com, go under the Contact Us page, and put your email and name in so that we can stay connected, and I can send you all the information about where I'm going to be next, and you can come out and support me, because I'm going to be doing shows with y'all. So I want to make sure y'all come out and support. Again, who that?
Y'all, thank you so much. God bless. All right. Now give the lady of Brooklyn kind of applause, y'all. Make sure you sign our mailing list so that we can let you know when she's coming back, or she will be back.
Okay.
And all these guests that sound so good, give the band a hand. Yeah. It was fun. Yeah. Very fun. All right. So, thank you so much.
Thank you.
I'm sure you all had a good time.
Yes.
We're here 4 nights a week, Thursday through Sunday. Keep in touch, because there's always something good. All right.
Take a picture. Can we shine? Phone. I need to take a picture of this because this is my first show. Like, I promoted this show by myself. There was nobody else in the bill, and it's in New York. And look at this room.
Yeah, all right. Yeah.
Like, seriously, maybe I should be in it. We looking at Pat up there. Or Tony, are you taking a picture too?
I got a recording, so.
Oh, okay. Well,
look, franchise.
Okay, Suzann.
Suzann!